so that we can proceed.
Ma'am, if you can give us 5 minutes so that we can introduce you to the rest of our participants as well.
Sure, sure, ma'am, sure.
Thank you, ma'am. Well, the capacity to learn is a gift, and the ability to learn is a skill, but the willingness to learn is a choice. With this, good evening and Jai Hind to all the professors, research scholars, and dignitaries of the college. Ashok Kamna Singh, Activity Coordinator of Sembeem Women's College, Varuna, takes the opportunity to welcome you all in the second session of first day of Faculty Development Program organized by Sembeem Women's College, Varuna, Varanasi, under the aegis of IQAC on theme Contemporary Teaching Pedagogy for Innovative and Experimental Learning. Well, for the second session, we have amongst us Dr. Anisia Planker. Ma'am is an associate professor and has more than a decade of experience in academic presentation. She is working as an associate professor and a program coordinator in Institute of Business Management, GLA University, Mathura, Uttar Pradesh. Well, she did her PhD in the field of diversity and inclusion. She's key teaching and her research interests include workplace, diversity, inclusion, organizational behavior, and talent management. She's an avid researcher and got various international and national research publications on the repute of her name. She also received many research papers of the category of journals, books on business communications of Tata McGill Hill Education Private Limited. Well, on behalf of Sembeem Women's College, Varuma, we welcome you, ma'am. Ma'am will be sharing her resource knowledge on topic ITC tools for professional development and class engagement. Now request Dr. Manisha Singh, Academic Head of Sembeem Women's College, Varuna, to welcome our eminent speaker for this session. Well, I hope we have Manisha ma'am here.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm here. Yes, ma'am. Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Yeah. So thank you, ma'am. And good evening and Jai Hind to everyone. Ma'am, it's a privilege for me to welcome you, ma'am, here in our 10 days faculty development program. And we're also grateful to you that accepting our invitation and giving us opportunity to listen to you. So we are looking forward for this same. And once again, welcome you, ma'am. And over to you, Shukamna, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Anisha Sangha, ma'am. The session is all open for you, ma'am. You can start with her.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your heartiest welcome. And thank you, everyone. I know that it's quite a hectic schedule for everyone since morning, so I can understand it. So let me just first thanks Sunbeam Women's College, Varuna, for giving me this opportunity to interact with intellectuals, in fact. And it will be like a very interactive session. And I would really appreciate that if you, during the session, if you, wherever you feel like, you can ask questions. Today, today what I'm going to discuss is related with ICT tools, that is information communication technology tools for professional development and class management. Now, to start with, in fact, why this particular theme has actually entered in my, clicked in my mind. In fact, these lines of Ray Clifford is the motivation behind today's session. And that says that technology will never replace teachers, but those who use technology will replace those who do not. It means that it's always a point of discussion that a day will come when this technology is going to replace humans. And same is the case in education industry, specifically in higher education system. But it's very rightly said that, in fact, in the coming years, in the coming decades, it's not the technology which is going to replace specifically the teachers, but in fact, those who cannot use this technology for the benefit, for the betterment of the large, definitely they will be left behind. To proceed with, let me just share with you the important components, which will be the part of my today's discussion, and that is ICT in education. That is, what is its role with special reference to higher education system. What is the paradigm shift in modern teaching? What is the importance of modern teaching? What are the characteristic features of modern teaching? And what are the methods which is available to us? And many of the things which we actually don't know. So I will be sharing few of the things. Many of the things people might be knowing. And a few things which you can incorporate in your teaching, specifically when we're talking about online teaching or even an offline teaching, to make it more impactful. So next will be, now today's era is basically Teacher 2.0. It is a newer version of teacher. And that is a teacher who is able to imbibe technology in them. So what are the tools by means of which we can professionally develop ourselves? And then few of the ICT tools that can make our teaching more effective and more impactful. In fact, if we talk about that the world we live in is basically a result of constant change. What might be there one day, which is never there the next. So look at what has happened with COVID-19. In today's society, people as consumers of ICT all strive for one dream. And what that dream is? The dream of connected life. This makes ICT a lifestyle choice for much of the population. In addition, in fact, this lifestyle choice is changing the way we are communicating, increasing the rate of consumerism, changing how we interact with others and how we gather information. Now, no matter how we perceive its presence, we can't deny one fact. And that is a very important part of our lives. And that is, here it is going to stay, and that is technology. And these, since COVID-19, since last 1 year, the unprecedented change which the entire world has witnessed actually has brought into a new era. And that is the time of online learning for all people. If we talk about see the reports, specific reports in the line of with respect to this ICT in education, we will find that according to the report of National Institute of Multimedia Education Japan, it is a proven fact that if we are integrating technology to the curriculum, it has a very significant and positive impact on students' achievements, that is students' academic outcome. Now, the results specifically showed that the students who are continuously exposed to technology through education has better knowledge, excellent presentation skills, they have innovative capabilities, they are ready to make efforts into learning as compared to their counterparts. It also enhances students' exposure towards external world. Further, it also facilitates genuine communication. It improves their ability to involve in various set of activities, ability to give feedback, whatever they are learning. And in this way, all these things also facilitates in sustaining their motivation. Now, if we talk about this new generation, the present is basically the generation when we talk about with respect to learning, it is M-learning. M-learning means mobile learning. So M-learning, that is mobile learning, what we are witnessing today, is basically a form of e-learning. And it is a rising trend nowadays, because we have seen that many of us used to take our sessions on either through our, we used to take sessions on mobile, our students take, listen to us on mobile, or at times there are so many programs which we are attending and we are actually using this mobile learning. And where this education has outgrown the physical constraints of the classroom. So there is no any constraint with respect to there should be proper place where everyone is sitting and there is a face-to-face interaction. No. And this has resulted into increased mobility. Now, This resulting into students can access information whenever and wherever they want. And in fact, the institutions that provide such advanced technological terrains is rising in number day by day. And in fact, I must say that it's not about the requirement, or it's not about up to the will of the institution, but it has become a necessity, a compulsion which every single institution, whatever size or whatever infrastructural facility or whatever resources they have, irrespective of that, they are supposed to grow all these things. Which means that there is a paradigm shift in modern teaching. And this shift is what? This shift is basically a shift from teacher-centered to student-centered. When we are talking about teacher-centered to student-centered, it means now the teaching pedagogy, which teachers are using, it is not concerned with whatever things are in whatever areas a teacher is trained. In fact, it is actually based upon the requirement, the need of the student. I will be discussing in detail that there are different categories of students, and it becomes at most important for the teacher to understand that category, and at the same time, within that span of time, targeting all the three categories at the same time and keeping a pace with that. So there is a shift in that, and when there is a shift from teacher-centered to student-centered, then it specifically reflects that one has to use certain resources, which is already available. It's not like that we have to develop certain resources. These resources are already available, and how effectively we can use it, it actually that indicates how much successful we will be in our delivering the outcome. Now, there are certain resources, these resources which are available to us, but many times due to lack of knowledge, due to lack of confidence, we generally don't use it. But the teaching resources, in fact, what are the teaching resources that facilitate this paradigm shift from teacher-centric to student-centric? We can categorize into various ways, like there are certain teaching aids. Teaching aids means how we are transferring that particular knowledge. So some teaching aids is like blackboard, some are whiteboards. At times in schools, even in higher education institutions, people are using photographs, felt boards. Games also is being conducted so as to make students understand the concepts. There are various electronic resources also. That is basically without any computer which we can use, and which is actually used traditionally also. These resources were used like tape recorders, like video players, like slide projectors, LCDs, overhead projectors, television, and all these things. But this is a shift. And then this shift is actually moving towards your ICT-enabled things. Then after that, electronic but without computer, then came this computer-aided things like language labs, specifically when we are conducting sessions to improve the communication skills of the people, the body language of the individuals, that is working on body language and paralanguage of the students. Then in that case, language labs are really very effective ones. Then electronic whiteboards for that smooth transition of the information. Then presentations, websites, blogs, Skype, podcast, all these resources are actually available. And it is used not only in case of these were the resources which are used in offline to make teaching more effective, to make it more impactful, and to make the entire session more attractive. But now there is a shift in all these things. Now, what this shift is? This shift is actually talking about the modern teaching methods. Now, in fact, there are modern teaching methods. It's actually the time for the change. A change which has not occurred phase-wise, but we have actually not imagined that it is going to happen. but we are into it. I still remember when our institution in 2020, in March, when it was actually declared by the government that we are going to have complete lockdown, and suddenly actually in classes we were using all these resources we have, I have just discussed with you all right now, using videos, presentations and all these things. But as it was said that now we have to conduct online classes, that was a transition. And the transition was, very honestly speaking, I have never heard at that time, I have never heard about Zoom as a platform. There's a platform called Blackboard, Google Meet. We don't know. In fact, and when it was told that this is the link, this is how you are supposed to map the lectures, take the sessions, do the recordings. At the same time, students also, it was a very new process. Some were very notorious. मतलब कुछ अनजाने में बदमाशी करते थे क्लास में स्टूडेंट्स, और कुछ जान के करते थे. एंड एट द सेम टाइम ट्रैकिंग दैट इफ द क्लास इज ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ 100 और 60, एट द सेम टाइम यू आर सपोज टू टीच देम, यू हैव टू एंश्योर दैट एवरीबडी इज लिसनिंग, यू हैव टू एंश्योर दैट they are understanding at the same time, and at the same time to find out किसने ब्लैकबोर्ड पे लिखी हुई चीजों को कलर कर दिया है या उसको स्ट्राइक ऑफ कर दिया है. सो आइडेंटिफाइंग दैट आल्सो, सो एज टू टेल देम दैट वी नो एवरीथिंग. इट वाज रियली वन आवर सेशन वाज सो एग्जॉस्टिंग दैट आई नेवर फेल्ट व्हेन आई यूज्ड टू टेक ऑनलाइन लेक्चर फॉर मतलब एट अ स्ट्रेच टेकिंग 2 to 3 लेक्चर्स एट अ टाइम. आई नेवर फेल्ट दैट आई वाज एग्जॉस्टेड, बट इन वन सेशन वन लेक्चर ऑफ ऑनलाइन इनिशियली आई फेल्ट आई एम टू मच एग्जॉस्टेड. एंड देन ट्रेनिंग वर गिवन स्विचिंग फ्रॉम Zoom to Blackboard, then from Blackboard to Zoom, and then to Google Team. And it was like, I don't know, I never thought that I will be so creative. And you know, with the passage of time, we human beings are so, we are very smart. Hum bahut smart hote hain. Aur thodi si cheezein agar hame bata di jaye, agar hum dekh le, to fir hum pareshaniyon ka khud hi hal dhoond lete hain. सिर्फ सिखाने की जरूरत नहीं है, हमारा दिमाग अपने आप चलता है. बहुत अच्छा स्टडी हुआ है, कोलमैन ने ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल बिहेवियर में ये स्टडी किया था लर्निंग पे. सो एट द सेम टाइम इट ऑल हैज हैपेंड, लाइक यू कैन सी. आई डोंट नो आप में से कितने लोगों को मेरा नाम दो जगह दिख रहा होगा. एक में मैं बोल रही हूँ और एक में मेरी फोटो दिख रही है. So let me tell you why this has happened. Suddenly when I just opened my system, I realized ki mere laptop mein voice clear nahi aa rahi hai. What to do? Presentation is the laptop. Bas 5 minutes start hone wala hai. Kya karna hai? And then it just clicked in my mind ki mere phone se meri awaaz jayegi, mere laptop se mera screen share ho gaya, and I will be taking the session. So what I mean to say is that ek time aaj se 1.5 साल पहले हम इसी सिस्टम को लेके इतना परेशान होते थे, हम एग्जॉस्ट होते थे, और आज इस सिस्टम ने हमें इतना स्मार्ट बना दिया है कि हम मुश्किल में फंसते हैं और खुद ही उसका समाधान निकाल लेते हैं. अब बात यह है कि कैसे इस मुश्किल समाधान के बीच में जो टीचर एज हमारा कोर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है इज एक्चुअली ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग दी स्टूडेंट्स, विच इज अ वेरी बिग चैलेंज. वी ऑल कैन अंडरस्टैंड क्लास में आंखों में आंखें डाल के स्टूडेंट को मैनेज करना कितना मुश्किल होता है, और ऑनलाइन कैसे मैनेज करना है. बिकॉज एट द एंड आवर सक्सेस इज एक्चुअली वेड, इट इज एक्चुअली इवैल्यूएटेड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सक्सेस ऑफ द स्टूडेंट. इट्स नॉट अबाउट हाउ आई एम टीचिंग, इट्स नॉट अबाउट हाउ ब्रिलियंट आई एम इन माई सब्जेक्ट, हाउ फ्लुएंट आई एम इन कम्युनिकेटिंग. इट्स माई सक्सेस इज एक्चुअली डिटरमाइंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मेरे पढ़ाए हुए स्टूडेंट का परसेंटेज कितना है. वो जब बोलता है तो उससे पूछा जाता है तो वो कितना अच्छा बोल लेता है. इंटरव्यू में सेलेक्ट होता है या नहीं होता है, मेरा सक्सेस उससे डिसाइड होता है. सेकेंडली, जब मैं पढ़ा रही हूँ, व्हेन आई एम टेकिंग क्लास, आई एम नॉट अनीसिया, मेरी इंडिविजुअलिटी नहीं है. बाहर आई एम जीएलए यूनिवर्सिटी, आई एम नॉट अनीसिया. अच्छा करूंगी तो जीएलए अच्छा कर रहा है, खराब करूंगी तो जीएलए सही नहीं कर रहा है. So huge challenge. That means you have to manage all those things. So if we look at all these things, that is modern teachings, which is actually required. I rightly agree with this point that, see, everyone is a genius. Rightly said by Albert Einstein that everyone is genius, as I have just shared few of my own experience. But if we start judging a fish, that a fish is not able to climb a tree, then it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid. What I mean to say, एक fish जो पानी में रहती है और उसने अगर ये देखा कि अरे ये बंदर बड़े आराम से tree पे चढ़ जा रहा है, मैं तो चढ़ ही नहीं सकती हूँ, तो मैं तो सबसे मूर्ख हूँ इस दुनिया में, अगर हम इस तरीके से सोचना शुरू कर दे, एक fish ऐसा सोचना शुरू कर दे, तो same हमारे साथ. तो इसका मतलब, what is required is to change ourselves. So if we say that what is a modern teaching, if we have to define it, then modern teaching is basically a method that focuses more on teaching the students and improving their intellectual behavior. Fine. And how we are trying to improve their intellectual behavior? We're trying to improve their intellectual behavior by new and innovative ideas, rather than making them rote or mugging up the syllabus, mugging up the content just before the examination and at the time of examination, just pouring it out. No, modern teaching is beyond that. In fact, if we see that over the years there have been, we have witnessed visible changes in the teaching style, which is just opposite to just what I said is memorization or just a recitation practice, which is being there among students. Ki ye hai and you are supposed to rote it, isko padh lena hai aur isko jab pucha jayega to as it is se ugal dena hai. No. Now this education reform, which has provided a very different angle of teaching and learning because of modern teaching methods, that in fact they do not teach students at the same level of understanding ability like initially the conventional method was, rather than the only teacher based modern teaching methods which focused on questioning, demonstration, explaining, practical exposure, collaborative method of understanding the things. And it is more of once a concept is being understood by a student or explained by the teacher, then in the form of activity-based learning, actually just ensuring that learning has actually happened. So the students of this 21st century, they should be taught in a manner so that they can tackle this entire system, this entire gamut of business, and which is actually technology-driven time, and which requires a very creative, innovative minds for the progress of individual society and in fact the nation. So in this way, what is the characteristic of a modern teaching? If you say that this is modern teaching, or to ensure that the way we are teaching our students, whether it is contemporary or not, these are few of the characteristics, salient features which that teaching method should incorporate. Now what is it? One is, method should be learner-centered. Learner-centered means the teacher only acts as a guide, and the all learning process involves the learners. That means the learners significantly appear as a dominating thing, as a dominating component in a classroom interaction. It is not like the everything the teacher is saying. It is more of encouraging the student to speak. Second characteristic is the method should be task-based or activity-based. That means a student must be encouraged, must be asked to take part in various classroom interaction through various interactive activities like role plays, like debates, like discussion, like extempore, like group activities sort of things. Third important characteristics is it should be resource-based. That means, now this responsibility is on us, that as a teacher, we have to be very resourceful. Resourceful in terms of information, resourceful in terms of data, resourceful in terms of various facilities, which we are actually catering or giving it to our students. So the teachers should be very resourceful. It means that they should collect from various sources. They distribute all the requisite materials which learners or which students will be requiring so that they can understand the things. And at the same time, making them involved in the understanding process among their own small groups. So that the resources can be collected from within the college or within the institution through books, journals, through various blogs, through various websites, communiques, or e-learning sources. From all these sources, wherever these resources are available, identifying the, and yes, at the same time, while collecting those resources, at the same time ensuring the authenticity of that resources, and then bringing all those resources to the learners so that they can understand it. So that is a resource-based. Next is, it should be interactive in nature. That means one-way communication should be not there. In fact, in modern teaching method, when we are talking about the very important factor is the entire methodology should be very interactive. And how we can make that interactive, or how we used to make it interactive, because I'm pretty sure that most of us are using these methods. And thus, we can ensure that we are not teaching our students in the same traditional way of teaching. We are not adapting. We have actually moved ahead, and in that way, we are actually using these modern methods. So the teacher, how they are making it interactive? The teacher asks questions, first dividing the entire class into small groups, and not on the basis of their interest. See, I'm just telling you on my own experience. Initially, I used to divide the groups or make groups. I used to give this autonomy to the students to make their own groups whenever I used to conduct any sort of activity or session or something. And then I realized ki aaj ka bachcha bahut chalak hai. Chalaki mein kya karta hai? Apna comfort hamesha dekhta hai. They never ever think about ki who is good with whom they can actually learn. They always see ki aisa kaun hai jo mere hisse ka bhi kaam kar dega. And they always form group like that. And whenever they are making their own group on their own choice, I have observed it. So now what I used to do, I randomly make groups. And once I wrap the first activity, I randomly make for first two activities, so that students can mingle with everyone, they can understand each other, and they should be able to handle a specific adverse situation. Once they are grown to the next level, out of those groups, identifying those students who have a leadership capabilities or who really work as team, identifying those students. So next time when I'm dismantling that group, and again now making group by means of that who can actually take up the group to the next level, so that they should be able to come out of their comfort zone. Because every time if they are working with their own circle or friend circle ke saath hi agar activity karte, they never come out of their comfort zone. So it's very important to challenge their comfort, so that because in corporate or whenever they are going out, it will not be like a cakewalk. So it's very important to prepare them for every single aspect. So in that way, forming small groups and then giving specific resources, tasks, and giving them time to, in fact, gel with their group members, work together with their group members with a sense of cooperation, and then come up with a solution for that particular task. So that it should be interactive in nature. Then it should be integrative in nature. Now, this is also one of the vital characteristics of modern teaching method, that it should be integrative. Now, how to make it integrative? Let me explain you in this way, that teachers should link topic of one subject. Now, subject can be related with like workplace bullying. It can be related with discrimination, workplace discrimination. It can be related with crime or pollution or violence or safety. It can be any of these issues, one topic, and making it integrative. Now, two or three topics, integrating two and three topics, and then asking the students to explore on those areas and come up with how all these issues or how all these factors are going to impact the youth, the industry, or whatever the case is. So that is integrating the topic and two or three topics together and coming up with a solution. Last but not the least is peer collaboration. Now, modern teaching methods, it not only encourage students by allowing them to participate there, to participate in various activities, share their ideas, taking initiative, or very minutely observing what others are doing, or just studying their research. In fact, it is more beyond that. And through instructional activities, students actually learn to work cooperatively, and they appreciate that their competitors also work well. So basically, the learner's interests are considered most important in that. And the teachers are actually the guiding force that guide them towards their goals and their careers. So these are the very characteristic feature of modern teaching. Now, what are the modern teaching methods? Now, let us understand it and how and where we can use these methods in our own teaching pedagogy. Let us understand it. There are various methods. I have just incorporated few of the prominent ones. Methods here means it is like an approach, the way we are making our teaching happen, learning happen among students. Now, one is collaborative learning. See, earlier, whenever a student is being asked to revise any topic or anything, something, content or something, what they used to do, they find some a place which is isolated, either at home or at the in the library, and so, and they are just they don't want anyone to discuss on the things, and they are just concentrating on the material which is being given by the teacher or the books and so, or from the books from the library and all that. Now, this practice of just revising from the study material or from the books, from the notes, it was widespread, and it was one of the integral part of traditional teaching methods. Now, to deal with this issue and to provide more useful backgrounds or platforms for students, now schools as well as colleges are coming up with collaborative learning. Now, in this modern method, what is there? Teachers form group of students, and these in that group of students, they are supposed to solve their own problems. They debate on specific topics. They clear their queries. And once they have cleared their queries in their group, and then they are actually expressing or presenting before the teacher. Now, this enables these students to basically present their ideas and expect that how this group learning is actually happening. Now, this this particular activity, this also provides space to exchange the creativity and gain more knowledge, because an individual is not just working on their own, they are listening to others. Probably if a problem comes in my way of taking up that problem will be something different. And at the same time, Manisha ma'am's or Nilanchana ma'am's perspective will be something different. But when we are discussing among each other, like jab hum ek dusre ke sath discuss karte hain, to ho sakta hai main realize ki is point pe meri samajh sahi nahi hai. Jo Manisha ma'am keh rahi hai wo valid hai, wo maine us angle pe maine dhyan nahi diya. And this is the beauty of this type of learning. Now, spaced learning jo mujhe, I'm very sure ki hum sab karte hain, अपने बच्चों के साथ भी करते हैं और अपने इंस्टीट्यूशन में भी करते हैं. स्पेस लर्निंग का मतलब होता है, इट इज बेसिकली वी आर रिपीटिंग लेसन्स और द थिंग्स व्हिच वी हैव कवर्ड मल्टीपल टाइम्स विद इन द सेम सेशन. लाइक से फॉर एग्जांपल, आफ्टर एवरी 15 मिनट्स आई एम अगेन कनेक्टिंग माय कंटेंट विद व्हाट आई हैव डिस्कस्ड 15 मिनट्स बैक. तो दिस इज हाउ इट इज हैपनिंग. ये बहुत अच्छा एक्सरसाइज है, बिकॉज ये मैंने यूज किया और मुझे इसका रिजल्ट दिखा. how it came into my mind. Let me share that incident with you. Very interesting. Ho sakta aapke saath aisa kuch milta julta incident hua. I am a person of HR. My specialization is human resource management, and my area of interest, apart from diversity and inclusion, is labor law and legislation. So in second year, I used to take this paper for HR students. Now, as you know, law is all about sections. It is all about complications. Aisa hai tohi aisa hoga, and all these things. I still remember online session, obviously, online class chal rahi thi, session le rahe the. One day, two day, there was one student. Woh bahut dhyan se sunta tha, bahut question, ajeeb o gareeb questions poochta tha. Ma'am, if something like this happened, then what is the right of the labor? What management can do? How government is going to intervene in all these things? So I used to explain him with certain specific sections. After three or four lectures, I randomly, one of my colleagues said, ma'am, have you noticed, have seen the status of that student? I haven't seen it. So in his WhatsApp stated status, online class chal rahi thi jo meri, uska usne screenshot liya aur usme usne apne status pe laga diya, labor law and it's so tough or something. So I took it as a challenge. मुझे ये पहले तो हंसी आई, फिर मुझे लगा कि ये बच्चा क्वेश्चन तो बहुत पूछता है, लगता तो था कि इसको बड़ा समझ में आ रहा है. And then I realized कि no, ये मेरा interest है, ये मुझे अच्छा लगता है पढ़ने में और पढ़ाने में. जरूरी नहीं है कि सामने वाले को भी उतना ही अच्छा लगता हो. तो I have to do something. और यानी कि जो प्रॉब्लम है वो ये है, बच्चे को इस बात का डर है, मजा उसको आता है पढ़ने में, लेकिन उसको इस बात का डर है, अंत में उसको जो प्रूव करना है उसको अपने एग्जामिनेशन से प्रूव करना है, और उस समय उसे सेक्शंस नहीं याद रहे तो सब खत्म है. एंड देन आई यूज दिस स्पेस्ड लर्निंग. हाउ आई यूज टू डू इट, व्हेनेवर आई यूज टू स्टार्ट अ पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक, एक्सप्लेन इट, आई मूव टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. While explaining the next topic, I connect it with the first topic and revising it up. So in this way, in my lecture of 50 minutes, almost 4 to 5 times, I have revised some of the important sections or points in my entire lecture. So at the end, what I have made to them, that now they are very clear, this very the spaced learning. We have to use other cases that A bolenge to ho sakta A or Z yaad rahe, helps us to do it. And in fact, this can be done through incorporating the things with various activities, mental activities we karte hain. I will show you, say aap log shakti karte hain, and that is in between the session we are there is option for poll. So if we are asking questions and asking the, we have just raised a question related with the topic which we have discussed 15 minutes back, and asking the students now answer dijiye, and then discussing on it. Activity dimag chalta hai, mental jo skill hai wo work karta hai. Online ki baat kar rahe hain. If you are talking about in class, then in class we can do this spaced learning by means of either discussion, just a small group discussion, or through role plays. So it's truly, this particular method truly defines a proverb that says that healthy mind is a healthy body, in fact. Now, flipped classroom. Flipped classroom, in fact, it's not anything which is very new. In fact, IIMs, IITs, and all these institutes of national repute or foreign institution, they use this system. Now, flipped classroom is what? Basically, this method is reverse of providing content at school and ask students to rework on it and to practice at home. So now what students are doing? Students are preparing themselves. The content is already given to this student, that whatever we are going to teach them in the next class, say on whatever we are going to teach them on in the Friday class, we are providing all the necessary resources or links to the students prehand and telling them, day after tomorrow we are going to discuss this point, and on this point we are going to do a case study or a particular problem or a question. come prepared with that. Now, students prepare themselves with the content before or they can before arriving the college. If they face any doubt, they are matlab like they are set free to discuss among themselves in the classroom. Even they feel like they can discuss the things with the teacher. Now this is and then they are supposed to present whatever they have learned in the class and applying those concepts in solving the problem which is given to them. This is flipped classroom. This is very effective, but yes, we have to use this very cautiously because we have to see the intellectual level of the student. Every single student will not be comfortable in this pedagogy, that is flipped classroom. Kuch aise student hote hain, hum ek concept padhte hain, and that is how to train people. There are two things actually. One is willingness and one is capability. Willingness and capability, there is a combination of these two. If a student is willing to learn something, kitna bhi mushkil hoga, kitni bhi pareshani dijiye, wo learn kar lega. If a student is unwilling to learn something, aap usko kitni bhi cheeze de dijiye, aap wo nahi learn karega. Capability pe hota hai, kshamta hai ki nahi, yani ki pehle se thoda bahut knowledge hai ki nahi. तो ये कैटेगराइजेशन देखना बहुत जरूरी है अगर हम फ्लिप्ड क्लासरूम कर रहे हैं. कुछ ऐसे स्टूडेंट होते हैं जिनको गाइडेंस चाहिए, जिन्हें जो चाहिए कि पहले हमें समझा दो, हम समझ लें, सर वी कैन एक्चुअली वर्क अपॉन दैट. सो वी हैव टू यूज इट वेरी कॉशियसली, क्योंकि अगर हमने ऐसे किसी कैंडिडेट के साथ या ऐसे ग्रुप ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स के साथ हमने फ्लिप्ड क्लासरूम यूज किया जो एक्चुअली खुद से पहले जो चीजों को फर्स्ट हैंड नहीं समझ सकता है, तो हम शायद उसका मोरल डाउन कर देंगे. सो वी हैव टू यूज इट वेरी कॉशियसली. देन इज सेल्फ लर्निंग मेथड इज देयर. नाउ सेल्फ लर्निंग इज बेसिकली एक्चुअली क्यूरियोसिटी पुशेस द लर्नर टू लर्न न्यू एंड न्यू थिंग्स एंड ऑलवेज न्यू थिंग्स. Now this curiosity, basically students get motivated to explore new subjects or they are interested into. So we have to identify that whatever topic or whatever subject we are dealing into, obviously in every specific subject there are certain topics which is very interesting or which grabs the attention of these students. Identify those topics. If it is general one, like we can identify these topics in case of behavioral issues, we can identify related with economics, politics, with respect to nature or something. So identifying such topics instead of explaining them in the class or giving them resources, asking the student that this is a topic, now you search on your own and give presentation. I have seen that now even at school level, this self-learning is also happening. I've seen that. In fact, my kids also used to get topics like on earthquake, cyclone or something. Kuch nahi padhaya jata hai class mein. They said, this is your project. Make a PowerPoint presentation and explain to the entire class. And in this way, they are learning. And this actually, matlab bada interest aata hai. We are exploring the net. Hum net dekh rahe hain, videos dekh rahe hain, identifying, okay, this is how the things work or this is how people feel. And then giving understanding or presenting our understanding before the entire system. Gamification, that use of games is also one of the technique, like puzzles, brain games in the session. And then one of the method is VAC teaching. This is what I am talking about, categories, which that is V stands for your visual, जो हम देख के सीखते हैं. ए स्टैंड्स फॉर योर ऑडियो, हम सुन के जो सीखते हैं. और के स्टैंड्स फॉर किनेस्थेटिक, दैट इज थ्रू फीलिंग. सो हर एक स्टूडेंट्स की भी तीन कैटेगरी होती है. कुछ सुन के ज्यादा अच्छे से समझते हैं, कुछ देख के ज्यादा अच्छे से समझते हैं और कुछ फील करके ज्यादा अच्छे से समझते हैं. तो उसके लिए नाउ व्हाट स्कूल्स कॉलेजेस आर यूजिंग, इनफैक्ट ये 1920 में ये कॉन्सेप्ट यूज होता था to help children with dyslexia, जो बीमारी है उसको देखने के लिए. लेकिन अब ये टीचिंग में भी यूज होता है. दिस इज हाउ इट इज यूज बाय मीन्स ऑफ वीडियोज एंड ऑल दीज एंड मेकिंग द स्टूडेंट लर्न. और हम देखते होंगे, हमने छोटे बच्चों को भी देखा है, वो वीडियोज सुन के पोयम बहुत जल्दी लर्न कर लेते हैं, कॉन्सेप्ट ज्यादा जल्दी समझ लेते हैं, क्योंकि उसमें वो देख भी रहे हैं, सुन भी रहे हैं और फील भी करते हैं, क्योंकि सारी चीजें चलती हुई नजर आती हैं. एंड देन कम्स योर क्रॉस लर्निंग, दैट इज teacher should introduce new questions, new queries in a very formal setting. कुछ फॉर्मल सेटिंग में पढ़ा दिया और उसके बाद विजिट कराया नेचुरल सेटिंग में, इनफॉर्मल सेटिंग में, जिसे हम स्कूल कॉलेजेस में इंडस्ट्रियल विजिट्स कहते हैं, कंपनी विजिट्स कहते हैं, या हम टूर्स कराते हैं. तो जो क्लास में पढ़ाया वो जाके भी वहां दिखाया एंड देन आस्किंग देम टू प्रेजेंट व्हाटएवर दे हैव स्टडीड, व्हाटएवर दे हैव सीन, नॉट टेल अस द एंटायर लर्निंग. सो दीज आर योर सम ऑफ द मेथड्स. Now, very quickly, let us see, because I know that it's 15 minutes which is left. So let me just tell you what are the various tools for professional development. So one thing which is very rightly said, that in fact, our mind, it doesn't need, it is not a vessel, in fact, it is not a container that needs filling every time, that needs filling. But in fact, many of the things are filled. But in fact, to give that energy, to give that force, what we need is to ignite it. So it's very rightly said. Now, how we can ignite it? There are various tools. These are some of the tools. हो सकता है इसमें से आपको बहुत सी चीजें आपने सुनी होंगी. But let me just brief you. ICT tools like Genially, which is excellent for creating different content in interactivity and information, which is of high. And in fact, getting students hooked. Concentrate on specific things. Microsoft Teams, abhi aaj ke time mein bahut se FDPs, workshops, webinars is platform pe use kiya jata hai. Basically, it bring all the content together at one place. And it basically integrate into Office 365 and it facilitates in collaborative work. So in every single class, various materials can be cross-exchanged with each other and participants can chat with each other also. Then one of the application is Kahoot. This is brilliant one. Just explore it. Ye kya hota hai? Because it allows you to create quizzes and that basically helps to test the knowledge of the student, whatever they have learned in the class, how well they have understood it. So basically, there are four types of tests which is available in this particular program. And that is, it helps in conducting contests, puzzles, debates, or surveys and all that. Games are actually projected on the screen and then the participants can participate in that game. One of the ways Dropbox. This is basically accommodation space, with having different tools. Which files can be saved, like documents, images, or presentations, and so. Then one concept is WeTransfer. This is ideal system of exchanging the files, so without having to be registration or to register yourself with a particular account. But with this app, you can actually share the content, but the content should not exceed 20 GB. And it really allows for professional use. Then MyDomo is one of the best resources for creating mental and conceptual maps. Basically, it allows you to create and collaborate online with various participants, synthesize ideas, analyze and generate new things and solve problems. Now, visually, it basically helps to create and view infographics. So if, like, for example, if we are trying to explain something that is financial modelings or forecasting sort of things, trend analysis, then it helps to do that. It allows you to share the content you have created in social networks. If you have created that, then you can actually share through this mechanism. Now, there are few tools which is also available to make your presentation more effective, like Bouncy, that is make learning fun, and your creation and presentation tool make it more effective, impressive. Google Slides, at the same time you are explaining. Now, this is, I have attended few of the international FDPs and workshops. I've used it and it's very interesting. At the same time, you are explaining and using the slides to explain people. And at the same time, if you want to make certain changes or you have to write something, you are using these Google Slides. So that is very good. Lesson Up, it creates fun and engaging digital lessons. And Peer Deck, beautiful, very interactive lessons. You can create presentations. And Prezi, I suppose, ye to students bhi bahut samay se use kar rahe hain. If you want to show animated, a moving animated and more clear visualization of a particular thing. Prezi is very beautiful way of presenting your content in the presentation form. Now, to ensure whether whatever you have taught, there are a few application programs which you can use to ensure that, and that is to conduct quizzes. Google Forms are there, Genly is there to know that whatever you have made people learn, whether it is understood by them or not. There are certain online collaboration mechanism is also there. If you really want to collaborate, that at the time you want that if there is a group of 10 people and they have to work remotely, they have to work on a particular thing, on a particular page or a slide or something, then these are the ways without meeting at one point or every time sharing it with people, this can be used. That is, Google Doc is there, saving the things in the drive and giving access to the participants. So Google Doc, Google Slides and Google Spreadsheets. One of a few of the very effective way of basically doing for this collaborative works. And then this is since last 15 to 20 years, this apart from as this ERP system has developed, this online learning management system, every educational institution has developed it. Basically, what is online learning management system is, it is basically a cloud-based functional platform that helps to manage the contents, images, text, PDFs, and all these information. In fact, the grades or feedback of the participants of the students on that, and it's and this can be shared among instructors, students, participators, and the administrator who is taking care of this LMS. So a few of the example is Canvas and Moodle, and basically the benefit is that it organizes all the e-learning content in one location. First point, it provides unlimited access to the those e-learning materials which is saved on that particular system. Then is it also helps to easily track the progress of the learners. Learners kitna pad rahe hain. Ye LMS system aap dekhiye bahut se apps mein hai, Byju's hai. Ye bahut se hain jahan pe ye LMS system se hi karte hain. Ya hamare institutions bhi isi tarike se karte hain. Content is there and just seeing ki student how much student has learned. Jo upload kiya gaya hai content usko usne kitna pad liya hai ya kisne nahi padha hai to usko kis tarike se trigger karna hai ki move hai. Further, it reduces the learning and development cost also. Every time we need not to invest on that. Once a thing is stored, what they have to do is just access those resources and come into take it into practice. Now, at the same time, there are various tools for professional development which we are supposed to learn. If we haven't learned it, we have to be very developed our expertise in that particular area, and that is giving how to give online presentations, how to use these smart boards, smart book, wikis, class walk, blogs and podcasts and various websites. So this has to be really work, and every single thing has its own benefit in them. So what the current scenario is, whatever we have discussed, this is the current scenario. Many things we have learned, many things we know, many things we don't know actually. So the point is, the things, the entire world is transforming, specifically this mode of education, the mode of learning is transforming. So the, I just want to put these questions in every participant's mind as a facilitator, as a teacher, that are we really prepared for this transformation? What are those essential things? What are the essential components which is required to for the smooth transition of this transformation? Is there any additional proficiencies which we as a teacher has to develop, has to acquire? If yes, what are those and from where we can acquire them? And what are the transformations which are expected from educational institution? It is not only just confined to ki hame apne andar change lana hai. There is also need to change the system of the institution. So what is that thing which has to be changed? So if in that way, I just conclude that good teachers have to take ownership of technological territory, which we are seeing. through constant, consistent, connected, and fresh mechanism at the same time. There are a rising number of massive open online courses, जिसे MOOCs कहते हैं, जो NPTEL के through हम देखते हैं, UGC and Ministry of Education, they all are facilitating in that. If we see in private institutions में अगर हम देखें, तो Coursera है, Khan Academy है, Edx है. It tells us there is a huge demand for off the classroom facilities, and the future of our institution actually depend on whether or not we are able to satisfy these needs of our student. The policymakers who are making these policy, I'm talking about the policymakers at the government level, they accept that ICT in education can help these students to compete in the global economy by being part of a skillful workforce and all that. In fact, according to UNESCO, measuring ICT in education is very important to actually inform these policymakers while they are setting priorities, these national priorities in developing this infrastructural facility or ICT collaborations in education policy. And in fact, it is being made like compulsory, or it has enabled the institutions, because it's very useful in case of when institutions are going for NAC, NBA or EBIT accreditations. So the movement of education industry towards quality assurance programs has been picking up pace, and the NAC and NBA accreditations are evidence for this. So to promote and improve digital culture in schools and colleges, the government has instituted, in fact, the National Award for Innovative Use of ICT, so as to motivate the teachers as well as the educators for innovative use of ICT in teaching learning. So, carrot and stick hota hai na, ek to hota hai ki award do to people will be happy, theek hai, hume ye system use karna hai, lekin isko use karke mujhe kya fayda hone wala hai. So, government is coming up with these initiatives. So, to summarize, in fact, enabling ICT in education and making use of technology in education, it creates an easy to manage learning environment where the delivery of information is so much smoother and making the learning easier. So I just wish to end up my session. I suppose I'm on time. 4 minutes before time, I must say that education is actually not about learning the facts, but it's more about how we are training the mind to think. And these tools, which is available with us, we have to explore the more benefits and incorporate it in our pedagogy. And in this way, we will be able to actually train those minds, jiska onus, jiski responsibility hamare upar. So this is... with this, I'm open for if you have any query, any question you wish to ask, you can ask. Else,
thank you, Panika ma'am, for sharing your resourceful insight knowledge with all our participants and providing your valuable time to us. Yes, we have a few of the questions coming up with the participants. The first one goes as, come up, like many of the young students are not having ICT orientation and ICT infrastructure. So what is a way that you suggest them that they can use for those?
It's very true, because we also have students from from village background where connectivity is not there, where there's network connectivity issue is there. So what can be used is that the IT tools which I have shared with you, that is, if they are not comfortable in sharing the things online, that is live, then encouraging them to go ahead with video formations. This we can do. बहुत से students होते हैं कि वो camera on कर बोलने में उन्हें डर लगता है. पहली चीज़ ये. उनको पता भी नहीं है कि करना कैसा है. लेकिन आज के student को we have to convince them or make them understand that this is the need of the hour. You have to understand. Until and unless you're not able to express yourself, you can't do it. So encouraging the students through various small activities, either giving presentation, recording it, and then sending to the faculty. Probably network connectivity नहीं है कि वो live अपनी बात को रख सके, अपनी presentation दे सके. Videos बनाए और उसे send करें. Audios बनाए उसे send करें. And this learning can be made. And I suppose aaj ki date mein वीडियो फोन पे वीडियो बनाना और फोन पे आवाज रिकॉर्ड करना ये सबको आता है, इसमें कोई नहीं कर सकता है। टेक्नोलॉजी यूज करना मैं मान सकती हूँ, दे डोंट नो हाउ टू शेयर द पीपीटी एंड हाउ टू प्रेजेंट इट, प्रोबेबली नहीं हो सकता है, बट वी कैन एनकरेज देम थ्रू दिस मैकेनिज्म।
Thank you, ma'am. The next question we have is like, how ICT tools are beneficial for not interested students? Okay, I mean, you wanted to ask like, since 2 years students have been sitting back to their home, how can we divert their interest to through ICT tools? And don't you think ICT lacks somewhere a bit of personal touch?
It's very true. See, I do agree with that because whenever we used to take classes, we used to put on our camera, but students are not doing it. They're saying ki agar hum camera on kar denge to subah se shaam tak wo sara data exhaust ho jayega. Ye ek issue jaisa student batate hain. Point ye hai ki hame aise ICT tools ko identify karna hai jispe hum apne students ko training de sake, unhein samjha sake. टूल्स बहुत है, ऑनेस्टली स्पीकिंग अगर मैं बात करूं, अभी मैं आपको प्रेजी जो प्रेजेंटेशन का है, आई हैव सीन इट वे बैक 10 इयर्स बैक, मैंने इस पे इसको जब मैंने देखा था और जब मैंने इस पे खुद प्रेजेंटेशन बनाने की कोशिश की थी, मुझे बहुत टफ लगा था। देखने में सुंदर है लेकिन मुझे लगा कि इट इज वेरी टफ टू मेक ऑन दिस टूल, आई ड्रॉप्ड दैट आइडिया। सो पॉइंट इज दैट, जैसा कहा कि ICT टफ है, कैसे हम स्टूडेंट्स को एनकरेज करें? स्टूडेंट्स को हम तभी एनकरेज कर सकते हैं, स्टूडेंट तभी एनकरेज होंगे उस टूल को अडेप्ट करने के लिए जब उनमें अंडरस्टैंडिंग क्रिएट होगी। तो मेकिंग अ सिस्टम, मेकिंग अ प्लेस वेयर स्टूडेंट्स कैन रेज देयर प्रॉब्लम्स, देयर इश्यूज, देयर कंफ्यूजन्स, एंड एट द सेम टाइम दोज कंफ्यूजन्स आर सॉर्टेड आउट। अंटिल एंड अनलेस देयर इज अ टू वे क्लैरिटी एंड ट्रांसपेरेंसी इन कम्युनिकेशन, any even a simplest method you cannot use. Hota yahi hai, I have seen classes attend karte hain, bachcha class login nahi kar pa raha hai, wo enter nahi kar pa raha, uski attendance nahi map ho pa rahi hai, aur wo apni baat rakh raha hai lekin koi sunne wala, koi resolve karne wala nahi, usko koi samjhane wala nahi, yahi problem hai. To human jo touch hai wo hame back end pe dena padega, aur shayad isi liye ek back end ki team create karni padegi jo in cheezon ko process कर सके। what one thing can be done, ऐसे सारे लोग नहीं होते हैं, 50 के बैच में या 60 के बैच में ऐसे 10 स्टूडेंट जरूर होते हैं जो सिस्टम को समझते हैं, encouraging those students to help and facilitate the other students, that can also be one of the mechanism of incorporating every single student at the same pace.
Thank you, ma'am. But the last one coming up is like, what are the techniques to scroll the legal subject while teaching substantive law?
See, ma'am, what I have done is that one way in basically in legal subjects, you can't give these study materials and ask them to do the homework. You have to explain it. Wo flipped classroom wala technique nahi chalta hai. You have to explain the students. To legal chips, every single word has its own meaning, a specific meaning and definition. So you can't ask these students, ye raha material, apne hisab se samajh lo. You have to explain it. Once you have explained it, then in the next class on the same topic, come up with real-time cases. Cases, there are various, bahut se blogs hain, bahut se communities hain, bahut se journals hain, jahan se cases mil jata hai. Giving those cases to these students pre-hand and asking them to go through it, and then in the class discussing with these students, in that discussion with that those particular real-time cases, and I tell you, nowadays there are small documentary videos. I haven't included because 1 hour mein main kya cheeze incorporate karti. Ek aur bahut acha tarika hai documentaries ka. आपको YouTube पे documentaries cases से related मिल जाती हैं, जैसे एक केस जो मैं HR में पढ़ाती हूँ related with industrial dispute, there is a documentary of more than 40 minutes, 40 to 42 minutes है, Maruti Manesar plant पे, entire documentary. I show that documentary to the students once I explain them what is industrial dispute. Show them that 40 minutes documentary and then asking them where was the flaw or what solution can So use of films, use of documentaries, use of videos can be the best way, or in fact, discussion. कोई भी लॉ जब भी पास होता है तो वो हमेशा पार्लियामेंट में डिस्कस किया जाता है, उसके उसके प्रो और कॉन्स दोनों डिस्कस करते हैं. बेस्ट वे ऑफ मेकिंग द स्टूडेंट अंडरस्टैंड, क्योंकि कई बार बच्चे पूछते हैं ये लॉ ऐसा क्यों है, इसको ऐसा क्यों बनाया गया है, ये तो बड़ा गलत है. तो जस्ट टेलिंग देम दी इफ यू आर शोइंग स्मॉल वीडियोज, ये न्यूज चैनल्स डालते हैं 1.5 से 2 मिनट का वीडियोज होता है जो पार्लियामेंट में डिस्कस होता है जब कोई बिल नया पास होता है, शोइंग देम एंड टेलिंग देम दीज आर दी प्रोज एंड दीज आर दी कॉन्स. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ दी वे ऑफ, और ये ऑथेंटिसिटी भी हो जाती है, ऑथेंटिक भी हो जाता है. तो दिस कैन बी डन. बट यस, ऐसे सब्जेक्ट्स जहाँ पे लॉ की बात करते हैं, यू कांट प्ले विद द थिंग्स, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू develop that conceptual understanding in the mind of the students. That's very important.
Right, ma'am. Like this question has been coming up twice a time. Like, what are the tools that can be used for accounting and finance?
See, accounting and finance is white boards जो हम classrooms में लेते हैं या Google Team पे जैसे sessions लेते हैं. Because होता क्या है, whenever we are using this Zoom, I have seen what teachers are using, वो word document open कर देते हैं और उसके बाद उस पर cursor से ही लिखना शुरू करते हैं. It takes time because चीज़ें उस writing में नहीं आती हैं या expressive नहीं हो पाती हैं. So in those case, accounting and all these things, further, एक चीज़ें मैंने और भी देखी हैं. Just to save the time and the energy or wo exhaust na ho, some faculty, what they used to do, they solve the entire thing in Word, मतलब कॉपी पेस्ट कर दिया एंड देन दे आर रनिंग इट इन द क्लास जस्ट लाइक अ पीपीटी. डोंट डू दैट. देयर इज वर्चुअल पेन आता है, वर्चुअल पेन एंड बोर्ड इज अवेलेबल, यूज इट. यू जस्ट कनेक्ट इट विद द सिस्टम, जैसे एक कीबोर्ड कनेक्ट होता है और वो स्क्रीन पे चलता है एंड यू आर राइटिंग ऑन दैट बोर्ड, दैट टैब सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग, एंड इट इज विजिबल ऑन द स्क्रीन. दिस हेल्प्स द स्टूडेंट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड इन अ बेटर वे. So that tool can be used.
Thank you, ma'am, for patiently answering all our questions and doubts of the participants. I now request our assistant administrator, Dr. Shalini Singh of Simbi Women's College, Varuna, to extend her vote of thanks to our guest speaker for today.
Thank you so much, Anisha, ma'am. Your session, it was a wonderful session, and I would appreciate your lecture. And we felt that as you were directly speaking to us. So, yeah, yes, ma'am. We never realized that you were over Zoom. I felt that as if we are sitting and you are delivering your lecture. Very beautifully you explained your modern teaching, the characteristics of modern teaching, and ICT tools for content creation. So, really, I appreciate your lecture. And entire session, ma'am, we were there. And like, you know, for a fraction of second also, mind was there in the session. My mind was there. And I hope it is applicable to everyone. So thank you for taking such a wonderful session, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And let me appreciate you people also, because I know since 11:30, the inaugural session and everything, and still you people look so fresh and energetic. So thanks to you also, because when we see such fresh faces, that gives us encouragement as well. That gives us motivation, or you say that refreshes, as a speaker, it refreshes us to move ahead. So thank you so much for this opportunity.
Thank you, ma'am. Well, to wind up this session, I would only say, like, education is the most powerful weapon which we can use to change the world. And change is the ultimate result of true learning. Well, with this, we come to the end of the first day of the second session of Faculty Development Program. Till we will meet tomorrow with more resourceful eminent speakers who will be sharing their knowledge and experience with us. Details and links about tomorrow's sessions will be shared in the WhatsApp group. Participants are requested to kindly join on time. And we expect all of the participants are filled up with their participation form and the feedback form, links of which have been shared in the chat option.
Ramna ma'am, can you please ask everyone to open up their video so that we can have one group photograph?
Right. Now, I request everyone to please switch on their camera so that we can make this FDP session a very rememberable for us. I request everyone to switch on their camera so they can have a good photograph with us. Thank you, participant, for being a patient listener to the speaker for today.
just one more minute and then we can move. Ma'am, we are good to go.
Thank you, participants. Until we meet again, I just end up with saying happy learning and happy teaching. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Thank you.